Hello everyone, next we are going to see some of the programs. So here we have one program, write an assembly language program to transfer n is equal to 10 bytes of data from location 8035s to location 8050 without overlap. So how this is going to work? So here we have the first instruction is ORE000H. So this is the start of the program where we are originating from the 000H location. Then we will actually start writing this code the 30H location. That's why sjump 30H, then ORG 30H. In the sense, this program whole code are written from the location 30H. Then move dph comma 80H. That is the dph data pointer higher byte is loaded with 80H. Then R0 is loaded with the 35H. So why this 35H? In the sense, we have a source address as 8035. So this 35H is loaded in R0. Then we have destination location is 50. So 8050, so this 50 is loaded into R1. Then here we have total of 10 bytes that we are going to move from this location 35H location to 50H location. So that is what we have kept the count in R3. That is R3 is loaded with 0H. So we know in the hexadecimal 0H, in the sense it is a 10 bytes. Then DPL, that is data pointer's lower byte, is loaded with the R0. So R0 is 35. That is the first address of the source address which is loaded to lower byte of the data pointer. So now totally we have on the repeater is 8035. Then we are going to load the repeater's first content into accumulator. Then we are going to move the R1 content into DPL. The R1 content is 50H, that is the destination address that is loaded into DPL. So now the DPTR total content is 8050. Next, that move X at it DPTR comma A. So accumulator's content is loaded into at DPTR, that is on the destination location. So we have taken from the source location and we are loaded into destination location. Then we are on incrementing INC R0, INC R1 like that. Then here we are using the decrement jump no 0 R3 comma back. So here we are going to check the content of the R3 each time. So if it is not 0, then it is going to repeat to the back. Then it is going to work for the 10 times and it is going to execute. So this is the logic behind this program. So we are going to see how practically it's going to work. So the same program I have written here. So first instruction ORG 000H, then sjump 30H, ORG 30H, then move dph with the 80H. So dph is loaded with 80H. Then move R0 is loaded with the 35H. So here R0 is loaded with the 35H. R1 is loaded with 50H. So here we have R1 loaded with the 50H. Then R3 is loaded with the 0AH. So here we have 0AH loaded on the R3. Then move DPL comma R0. So when you move R0 into DPL, so DPL is loaded with the R0, so DPL content is 35H now. Then move DPL comma R0 is over. Then move XA comma at DPTR. So at DPTR, so at DPTR content is right now it is 8035. So you can see it is right from 8035 to 803E. We have 10 locations, and on these 10 locations we have 10 datas available. So first data is 33, so that is what it is there on the 8035. So now the DPTR is pointing on this location, so the content of that one is 33. So here move XA comma at DPTR. In the sense, the first data, which is 33, this is loaded into accumulator, so it is available on the accumulator. We have 33. Then move DPL comma R1. So DPL is loaded with the content of R1. So R1 is 50H, so DPL is loaded with the 50H. So here we have 50H. Then move DPL comma R1. After that, move X at DPTR comma A. So accumulator's content is moved into the at DPTR. So DPTR now it is having the content as 8050. Here it is 80 and here it is 50. In the sense, 8050 we have. So accumulator content is directly moved onto the at DPTR. At DPTR, in the sense, the location on this location we are going to have the content of accumulator. Accumulator content is right now it is 33, so I'm going to move here 33h. So similarly, increment r0, so r0 is incremented to 1, so it is going to be 36. Then r1 is incremented to 1, so r1 is incremented to 51. Then decrement jump to 0, so r3 is initially it is 0h, that is 10 we have. So now it is changed to 9, so r3's content is 09h. Then it is checked, decrement jump to 0, r3 come back. In the sense, it is going to check the it is going to decrement the content of r3, and again it is going to, if it is not 0, then it is going to jump back to the this back label. Okay, so this is called labeling. Okay, so this whatever it is there is called label. Okay, on this location we are going to jump. Alright, so it is not 0, then it is going to jump back to this location. Now move DPL comma R0. So R0 content is 36. So DPL content is now again change to 36. Then move X A comma add DPTR. So here we have DPTR content as 368036, that is the second location. Now move X A comma DPTR. So add DPTR content, in the sense its content is 55, that is loaded into accumulator. So after this instruction, move X A comma add DPTR. So accumulator content is 55H. So 55, this 55 is loaded into accumulator. Now move DPL comma R1. So DPL content is change with the R1. So R1 content is, you can see here it is 51H. So here DPL content is changed to 51. Then DPTR content ultimately it is going to change. So it is going to be 51. Right. So now it is going to point to this location. Right. So this is a 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, and 59. Right. So now it is pointing to the 51. So the content of, so after this move X add DPTR comma A. So this accumulator's content is 55, that will be loaded into add DPTR. So here it is loaded. So 55 it is going to come here. So we will be having the 55. Then increment R0, increment R1. So R0 and R1 are incremented. So it is going to be 37 and it is going to be 52. Right. So now like this, it is gone incrementing. Then decrement jump to 0, R3 comma back. So R3 is decremented, so it is going to be 8. Then it is checked with whether it is 0 or not. It is not 0 obviously, and it is going to jump back to the this location, and it is going to retrieve the same execution. So whatever the values you can see here, all the values we are going to get on this location, that is from the location 80352, 803, all the values we have. So these values we are going to have from 8050 to 8059. So all the values whatever we have there on the 80352, 803, all the values are copied here. Okay, so this is how the program is going to be executed. So if suppose in the same program, if you want to make some changes, so instead of this 8035, in the examination they would ask you to write program where the location is somewhat different. Okay, so source location, if they are giving like something like 8000 location, okay, so as a source, and destination as 8200, right? So 8200 as destination. So simply what you need to do is, so here you just have to replace the R0R1 content. So R0 content it is treated as source and R1 content it as destination. Then it has to be a count, right? So how many numbers you want to transfer, based upon that you need to keep the count. So since I want to transfer the 10 bytes, so I have kept the count as a 0h. Suppose you have the 15 values that you want to copy it from one location to another location, then you can have 0fh as the count. So based upon the number of count, number of values you want to have transferred from one location to another location, this can be done, right? So this is how you can do the same program in different methods based upon the application, based upon the problem statement, what it is being asked. So you can change this, right? Okay, so similarly, you are going to see the result after the execution, how we are going to get the result on the Keel macrovision. So here you can see before execution, 8035 locations, we have this 10 values loaded on the 8035 location, and we are going to have on 8050 location, we are going to have the same values copied. Okay, so you can see 45H2 and 89H, we all the values we have, and these 10 values has to be copied. So 49, so from this location we are going to have copied all the values, that is 45 to 89. So here we have the 49, this is 49 location, then after this 49 we have 4A, 4B, 4C, 4D, 4E and 4F. So this is the 50th location, that's why it is going copied from this. Okay, so it is how it is going to work, right? So this is in the hexadecimal format, that's why it is 14. After the 14 we have, here it is 4A, then 4B, 4C, 4D, 4E and 4F. Okay, then all, then rest all values are going to be copied, right? So this is how we are going to have all the values copied from one location to another location. Then here one more thing is, like here it is given as MoveX, it is given. So it is, we are going to copy the data from external data memory. So that's why we are using MoveX A, addpt here, right? So we are seeing the concept MoveC, Move, Normal Move and MoveX, right? So when these things are used. So after this, we have one more program. So this program is written assembly level language program to exchange n is equal to 5. There is n 5 bytes of data location at the location 0027h and location 0041 location. So here in this program, what we need is, we have two locations being given, 27 location and 41 location. On these 27 location and 41 location, we have 5 bytes of data in both of them. Then we are going to exchange these bytes. Okay, so we are going to serve it to both. So we have this program ORG 000H SGM 30H. Origination, it will start from the 30H. Then after that, move R0, 27H. So this is a source address, and R1 is a destination address. Then here R3 is a count. Then move X A, at R0. So first value we are going to get, then the same value we are going to save it into R2 register, that is called as an intermediate register. Then we are going to copy the at R1 content, that is destination address, or the another what you can say here, we cannot say like source and destination, because both the locations having some values, so we are going to exchange them. Okay, so here we can call this as in a source one address, source 1, and this can be taken as source 2. So this can be called as in a source 2 address. So this is how we can treat it as. Okay, so these are the two locations. So we are going to have it in the R2, then at R1 the contents, so that is, this content is loaded into accumulator again, then accumulator's content is directly copied to the first this RZ location. Then R2 content, which is there intermediate, that is copied to accumulator, then the same value will be copied to the first location, that is this location, right? So increment R0 R1, and it is going to increment to the further location, like this is going to do it for the 5 times, right? So we are going to see how it actually or practically can be done. So here I have written this same program. So RG00SGM30H. So we are going to start with the first what you can say, the 30H address. We are going to start. R0 is loaded to the 27, that is source 1 address is 27H, and another source 2 address I could take this as So this is going to be source to address. So this is going to be A41H. So from these two location I want to exchange it, right? So R3 is 05. This is account mux a comma at R0. So here dph mux a accumulator is related with the at R0. So R0 at R0 content is what? So R0 is actually, you can see it is a pointer. So it is pointing at the location and it is having the value 44H. So that will be loaded into accumulator. So here accumulator content is going to be 44H. Then move R2 comma A. So R2 content is going to be, again it is 44H. So it is also 44H. Then move X A comma at R1. So at R1, in the sense R1's content is 41, so it is the second pointer where it is having certain value. So 41 move X A comma at R1. So here, so accumulator content is going to change. So here it is, you can see the 41H, in the sense 41 content is 00H. So I just have to change this, so it is going to be 00H, right? Move X A comma at R1. So this, after this execution of this instruction, accumulator content is going to be changed. Okay, then move X at R0 comma A. So accumulator content is 00H. So R1 content is, here it is, sorry, here it is, move X at R0 comma A. So here R0 content is 27H. So at R0 content, at R0 content is, in the sense this location, here we are going to load the accumulator's content. Accumulator content is 00H. So I'm going to load it here. Okay. So after this, move A comma R2. So R2 content is 44H, that is loaded into accumulator. So here I am going to have 44H. Then move X A, move X at R1 comma A. So accumulator content is 44H, that will be loaded into at R1. At R1 in the sense in this location. So here I am going to have as 44H. Right. Increment R1. So R0 and R1 are going to be incremented. So R0 is going to become 28. And R1 is going to become 42. So they are going to point to these location. Okay. Right. So in this program, we are not going to use any point data point registry, but here we are not using. After this, we are going to check decrement jump to 0 R3 comma back. So it is going to check the R3 content. It is going to decrement the R3 content, then it is going to check with whether it is 0 or not. Okay, so it is 5. So 5 is changed to 4. Then it is check if it is 0. It is not 0, it is 4. Then it's going to jump back. So this is the back location where it is going to jump. Okay, and it is going to execute the further, right? Move X A comma at R0. So next, at R0, in the sense R0's content is how much? You can see here it is 28. In the sense, it is pointing to this location. At R0, in the sense, this 66 value, that will be loaded into accumulator. So accumulator content is how much? It is 66. Okay, then move R2 comma A. So R2 content is loaded with the accumulator. So here again it is going to be 66. Then move X A comma at R1. So accumulator content is loaded with the at R1. At R1 content is how much? 42. So it is having 0 to H. Okay. So 0 to H is loaded with an accumulator. Accumulator. 0 to H. So after this, move X at R0 comma A. So accumulator content is loaded with the accumulator content is loaded on at R0 location. So at R0 location is this one. So here it is, instead of 66, it is going to change it as 0 to H. Then after that, move A comma R2. So R2 content is how much? It is, you can see 66, that is loaded into accumulator. So you can hear here 66H. So this content, accumulator's content, is loaded on at R1. At R1 in the sense this location. Okay, so at R1 content you can see 42. So it is pointing at this location. So here we are going to have the values 66. So likewise, we are going to copy all the values which are available here to here, and all the values which are there here to here. Likewise, we are going to exchange all the values from this location to this location. Okay, so between these two locations we are going to have the exchange operation, right? So in this case also you can use the dpt here also, right? If you want to have on the same location to be loaded all the values, like as we have done in the previous program. So if you want to have like two address location, A200 as one source and another 8300 as another source. So what you can do is you can take this 82 common in DPH and this 00 in R1 and this 00 in another location, right? So or what you can do is like this, you can do 82, so this can be 50. Okay, so 8200 and 8250, so this 82 can be taken into DPH, this 00 can be taken into R0, and this 050 has taken into R1. So as it has been done in previous program, similarly you can go where you can load this R0 and R1 at the instance whenever it requires. Okay, so if you want to access this location, DPL has to be loaded with a, suppose let me give in brief 8200 and this has 8250. Okay, so this, in this case what you can do is if you want to access this location, so in this case we need to have R0, so it is 00, and here in this case we have R1 and it is 50. So whenever you want to access DPTR, so if you want to access this location, R0 has to be loaded on the DPL. Okay, so this has to be constant as 82 only. Whenever you want to access this location, R0 has loaded, R0 is equal to 00. So if you want to access this location, here we need to add DPL is equal to R1 is equal to 50. Okay, so this is how you can have two different locations. Then you can go on incrementing the R0 and R1 value. Then again you can keep it into loop for how many values you have kept the count for. Then you can have the exchange operation. Okay, thank you.